Here is my list of 11 must-dos that I made with one of my students who now studies engineering at an IIT. Number one is finalize the books and resources you wish to study from. Do this right in the beginning and you should study primarily from them. And here I'll give an example of a student who got into an IIT last year. So for physics, for conceptual understanding and numerical problems, he picked Fundamentals of Physics by Halliday and Resnick and Sears and Zamansky's University Physics as another book for topics where Resnick and Halliday was not able to give him enough clarity. He also used Sears and Zamansky to solve more numerical problems. Then he finalized 3 YouTube channels, including Khan Academy, Walter Lewin Lectures, and The Science Cube for further study. So 2 books and 3 YouTube channels were his primary source of study. Beyond this, he used other books and YouTube channels only when he needed to. So the underlying idea here is to avoid studying from too many books. Switching between several books and YouTube channels makes you lose focus and your efficient time utilization falls. Remember, when preparing for such exams, every hour of the day is important and you do not want to waste time shuffling between several sources. Number 2 is start by learning the theory well before you do numericals. So do not rush into solving problems without an understanding of theory. You might end up solving a lot of problems with only partial understanding and you'll get stumped if you get a problem that is a little twisted. So make sure that you dive deep into the topic at a theoretical level really well before you attempt problems. So that takes us to the third one, that is practice. Do a lot of mock tests. I suggest at least 1 in a week and more in the last 3 months before the exams. When you do mock tests, apart from getting more and more practice in solving problems, the other important benefits are you get attuned to the pattern of tests, you start doing a lot better in completing tests in time, and most importantly, when you sit in the actual exam, you will be a lot less stressed since your brain would have got accustomed to the exam-like situation, or in other words, your brain will not be surprised by the examination hall and the feel of a real test paper in front of you. And you got to remember, in such exams, mind control during the exam is as important as the entire year of hard work. Number 4 is take proper nutrition and exercise. So good nutrition plays a big role in your brain's performance, energy level, and focus. So make sure your consumption of high quality food is adequate and junk food is less. Equally important is to get some exercise every day. So when you study long hours, the brain tends to tire and the performance falls. A bit of stretching and a short walk can really reset your body and brain back to your near peak performance. And if you can stay near your peak performance for a good part of your day, you again have an edge over others. Remember, a refreshed mind plays a big part in keeping you motivated. And yes, very importantly, drink plenty of water to keep your brain hydrated. So that brings us to number 5, which is have designated time to check social media messages. So anything that is outside your study resource, like the YouTube channel, you should use sparingly. I would say that you should keep your mobile phone in another room while studying. So Dr. Cal Newport explains in his book Deep Work that to succeed, you should be willing to work deeply without distraction, and the ones who develop this skill will have a clear advantage over others. The 6th one is understand your body clock and make the best use of time of the day by organizing study time. So what it means is morning to noon, when your brain is at peak performance, you should tackle difficult topics that you need to master or say something new you wish to learn or do a mock test that may require you to focus 2 to 3 straight hours. Then afternoons can be used to do revision of something that you're familiar with or maybe do a bunch of questions on a topic that you are a little more comfortable with. Evenings again can be used to work around topics that you've tackled in the past and are not brand new, or you could watch the preparatory YouTube channels like the Khan Academy or the Science Cube. Also, sometimes we are in a situation where we are outside the house, say in a taxi or a metro, or waiting for someone somewhere. For such times, always keep an earphone with you and watch your study YouTube channel for relevant lectures. So the seventh one is, do not burn yourself out studying. It is humanly impossible to study 12 hours a day, even for 30 continuous days at high efficiency levels, leave aside the whole year. If you want to remain productive, indulge in something that you like, of course, in moderation. The idea is to keep the brain at a level that can make it perform at its best. Well, I suggest a 10-minute break every 1 hour and a 15-minute break every 3 hours, because a refreshed mind would deliver much better results and keep you closer to peak performance as against very long hours of study without a break. So play a game, call a friend, listen to a song, but be disciplined about the break and get back to the study desk at the right time. So that takes us to the eighth tip, and that is, get at least 7 hours of sleep every day. So most of us believe that we should sleep less and devote those hours to studying. However, few of us know that your brain's functioning and productivity will be higher if you get adequate sleep, because sleep allows a brain to build memories, repair damaged muscles, and helps us fight viruses. Your ability to absorb difficult topics will go up significantly if your body and mind has slept well. So make sure you get into the bed in the night around the same time every day and get up at the same time in the morning and clock 7 hours of sleep at least. So now you are 1 day away from the exam, and that brings me to the ninth tip. That is, relax on the day before the exam. Rest your mind completely for the most important day. Do not walk into the exam room with a cluttered and a tired mind. So keep a light study schedule that may include just reviewing the areas that you may wish to have one last look. Do not get into the mode of solving another 50 numericals the day before. Make sure you sleep 8 hours a day before the exam, because you want to be in peak state of mind and body when you put your pen to the paper in the exam hall. So let the body rest really well the day before the exam. And now you are in the examination hall and the exam paper is right in front of you, but you are not stressed because you have done several mock tests and your brain is accustomed to this situation. So the 10th tip is, select the questions you wish to attack first. So here is a strategy I suggest. Let us say a typical question would require about 4 to 5 minutes to do. Read the question carefully to the end. If you believe that you can answer the question very easily, just start writing the answer. If you feel that you can crack the question, but there seems to be a bit of a twist in it, take about a minute to understand and start solving once you have thought through. If the question looks difficult and you believe it will require at least 2 minutes of thinking before you can attempt, I would say move on to the next question and get back to this question later. This approach has two important benefits. One, you build confidence since you're cracking questions early on, and this confidence can help your brain perform even better. Number two is, you are able to finish the paper in the given time and not miss out on the questions that you could have easily scored. In other words, you've avoided wasting your time on questions where your chances of cracking was low, while at the same time, you got back to those difficult questions in the end when you had some time left. So that brings us to the 11th and I believe the most important tip. So sit up and listen carefully. Well, the truth is that when preparing for an exam, you will feel anxious and worried throughout the year. You must realize anxiety comes from fear, and it can also be a motivator. Fear makes you work harder. So firstly, you should know that almost everyone feels anxious all the time. Anxiety is built into our DNA, and this is the way we are. It is just that some of us are more anxious than others. But you must ask yourself, which is more useful for effectiveness, being less anxious or more? Of course, being less anxious will help you prepare better for the exam. And if you look at a samurai warrior in a fight with another warrior, the calmer warrior will always win the battle. So do not waste your energy by being anxious. If you can stay calm and be composed as you go about your studies, you will have the ultimate unparalleled edge over others. So if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And please do not forget to subscribe to this channel for many more interesting videos.